Hi, this is Dan Sullivan. I'd like to welcome you to the Multiplier Mindset Podcast. Today's Free Zone success story is Tim Thacker, and Tim is a great friend and a great client and strategic coach that I've known for more than a dozen years, and he's from that beautiful part of Southeast UK, you know, south and east of London, on the way to the South Coast, and a beautiful area called the South Downs and the Surrey Hills, and, you know, just extraordinarily beautiful 1,000-year-old towns and everything, Farnham in the UK. And Tim is a very, very different kind of entrepreneur. If I think about, I've coached 6,000 entrepreneurs since 1974, and I would say that Tim is one of the great exceptions to the rule that most entrepreneurs come into the program and they have a single company. They stick with that company and that company gets bigger and bigger and, you know, it becomes a self-managing company, it becomes a self-multiplying company. But the company is almost like a single ability in the marketplace. Tim, you know, I think since I've known him, might be in the 20s, the number of companies that he's had. I've got pretty big bandwidth as far as different kinds of entrepreneurs. And I just find it fascinating that he can have so many plates in the air as an entrepreneur, you know, because he's really juggling a lot of different. He started off as a dentist, you know, and if you meet him, you'd be afraid to be a patient with Tim because he's got so many ideas. And the last thing you want your dentist to be doing while he's working on you is having ideas. But he's just a joy to know. He's got a wonderful sense of humor. But the big thing that he had to crack, and I don't try to change entrepreneurs. I said, you know, don't focus on all these other companies, you know, just focus on one company because everybody's got their own path in entrepreneurism. And it's my job as a coach just to, you know, identify how in relationship to the way that Tim is going about doing things, what he needs to feel, one, that he's on top of everything, and what he feels to need that all this different kind of entrepreneurial experience is really making him a better entrepreneur. And he's getting a lot of enjoyment out of it in his business life, but also it's flowing over and pouring out to his personal life.
My name's Tim Thacker. I'm a dental surgeon from the UK. I've got a big clinic outside London. I've been in the dental industry for many years. That's my main industry I'm involved with. And I've been a strategic coach for 10 years now, 7 years in London, and then 3 years over in Toronto at the 10X Group. It's certainly helped shape how the businesses are run and also the direction that I've gone in. And I'm now involved in other businesses apart from the dental business that I wouldn't have thought I would have been. And it's great to be able to come to a community of other entrepreneurs who can share ideas, and you realize you're not just the audible that no one understands. And it makes you feel a little bit more normal, which is great. And there's a lot of brilliant tools that help you think about problems in a different way. And that allows you to delegate better and also, I find, to help hire better. So we've actually got better support team. And also we've got our teams involved over the years, and some of our managers have come on Strategic Coach Team Tools. And that's made a massive difference because they can understand the same language that we're talking. So over the 10 years, the biggest impact has been with the businesses where the rest of the team are now earning the money. So it's not all down to me anymore, which is great. And over that time, I suppose my wealth has probably tripled. But I've been having great fun along the time, which is probably more important. I think the most important thing is because when you're running a business or you've got multiple pressures on you, and it's very easy to get your head down and just keep plowing on and might find you're actually going in the wrong direction. And then you look up and suddenly a year or two's gone by and you go, oh, what's happened? So really getting out of that situation every 3 months allows you to stop, put your head up, have a think about really, are you heading the right direction? Are things going well? And just allows you just to stop and take a big pause and I find that really I have a few days to sit down and have a total rethink about every aspect of one's life and make sure it's heading in the right direction. If it isn't, then pull it back and get it on the right track again. When I come to Toronto, I'm usually here for about 5 days, and those 5 days are very precious because it allows me time away from everyone and everything just to sit down and have time to think and plan about the future. And I find what I can achieve in those few days really sets me up for the next 90 days incredibly well. And what I've noticed over the last couple of years in the 10X is things are now happening really much easier, and I seem to be delegating more to the teams. And in the past, I used to have massive to-do lists. I went back sort of 5-6 years ago. Now I only focus on 4 or 5 things only, and the results that comes from those are about 10 times what I used to be from my 150 to-do lists get done in the next 90 days that only got half done. I think the results have happened in two main phases. So the first phase, when I was doing strategic coaching in London, which was probably about 3 years, and that was about getting the teams organized, getting my head sorted out from the point of view of learning to delegate more and trust and build up a good management team, and also understanding the concept of unique ability and working out actually what I'm really good at and not do anything else. So that was the first phase. And then with the 10X, again, I think actually I look back, it's probably been 3 years again, because I've just come to the end of the third year and I look back when I first started and thought, oh, one of the goals was to be involved with a load of other businesses and I wasn't sure where and what. And now I look at it and I go, well, wow, I'm looking forward to next year where suddenly I'm already involved in several businesses. Most of the businesses are running without me, and actually you can take me out of all of the businesses and they would survive and run and thrive irrelevant to myself now, which is fantastic. And next year I'm probably got about 170 days free off, and I'm probably only spending about 70 in the clinic and then another 70 looking at whole new projects, which is a load of fun for me. That's like great day of enjoyment. And then I've probably got about 50 days just doing some of the background stuff you have to do to make all the other stuff run, the thinking and planning. A lot of with unique ability, it's a big mindset change and having to understand actually you don't have to do everything. And it's actually much better to really focus on what you're really, really good at and just do that only, because A, you're better at it, B, you enjoy it more, gives you more energy, and you can just keep doing it forever. And the first time I came across the concept, I think you don't take it that seriously to start with. And it probably took a year or two to actually think about it a bit more. And then when I was over in Canada, we spent a lot more time, 10X with some of the coaches, working out a load more. Well, I probably spent 6 or 7 hours just focusing on what my unique ability is. That is totally different than what it used to be. And actually my unique ability is more about planning and working things out and making things stay on plan and analyzing and researching and keeping all, working out the best way of doing something. And that I can apply whether it relates to dental work or relates to startup businesses or existing businesses and how you can restructure them and make them run more efficiently and grow much faster. Taking the time out, effort to learn the new stuff and then actually then applying it. And I think, as Dan says, to what's the difference between the people who are very successful at it and who aren't, the ones who are very successful in whatever way you want to measure their success is they just get on and do it. They don't question it. And if you just get on and do it, you just suddenly find the results come easier and easier, which is not the way you would expect it to be. But I think it's worth talking to some other people who've been on it and actually just do it. I mean, life is too short not to just go for some of these things. And it does work. I mean, I'm not the only one. There's hundreds of other entrepreneurs who've found massive benefits. So we can't all be wrong. Yeah, there's a couple of friends of mine I've known for quite a few years. They were interested in what I was doing. I remember we went down for a pizza years ago, and he was asking all about what I was up to and how I made the clinic grow and what I've been doing. And I said, oh, went to a strategic coach, and that really helped. And he signed up, and he's been doing strategic coach for maybe about 4 or 5 years now. And actually, he's come out on the 10X program. And actually, my colleague Neil, he was on the FaceTime this morning, actually, having a chat, and he said, just remember it, this is the best thing you've ever done for me, recommending you to the strategic coach, and will ever be grateful for you. And his whole life has changed dramatically as a result as well, from moving into other areas, and we're actually looking at some projects together. And a couple of other friends have also come on it, and again, they've all had similar results. No one I've known or recommended has not had a great result and got more achievement and much easier successes. So it works for more than just me. It works for loads of other people as well. So good program. In fact, we just set up a new business and moved it to London and set all the new team before they even started the business off the team tools. And that has made a great impact because everyone is really keen, enthusiastic, understands what we're trying to achieve from day one and help build a much better culture for the business, which is great. And I think you need everyone involved. And I know a lot of entrepreneurs are reluctant to spend their money sending their team, but actually if you invest in your team, it'll pay back 10 times over or more. So, you know, it's a win-win for the entrepreneur, but also for the team members, because everyone, there's always some skills to learn that they can take on into life.
He's done a marvelous job for himself over the 16 years that he's been in strategic coach. The other thing is he's extraordinarily helpful and useful to the other entrepreneurs when he's in his workshop. And he's, you know, he's done collaborations with other entrepreneurs in strategic coach. And he started off, you know, dentistry is part of the medical industry, but he's more and more moving towards cutting edge, like stem cell treatment and that, and much more into companies that have very, very cutting edge medical technology. You know, really knows, just like every other entrepreneur knows, that if you start off in life and you've spent a couple of decades being an entrepreneur, there isn't anything else you're going to do for the rest of your life except be an entrepreneur. What I find so gratifying about it is that although it would be very, very confusing and complicated for me to have all these different businesses, and I think for most of the entrepreneurs in the program, they couldn't do that, he really understands that at the center of it, he's just the same person with every company. You know, he has a particular unique ability of giving purpose to other people's great capabilities. And then he's cracked the code on getting in each of his companies a top manager who actually manages the day-to-day execution. And he collaborates with the manager in each company to give them a vision for the next jump for the company. And so where in the beginning he might have thought he had 10 different hats to wear, he now knows there's just one hat that he has to wear. And he can have, you know, as many companies as is useful for him, you know. So it's a totally different kind of story. And I think, you know, at the center, it seems like a lot going on. There seems to be a 10-ring circus going on here. But Tim is just the same person. You know, he's got that central capability, unique ability that he's really great at. And then he allows other who's to actually manage and grow the other businesses.